And finally tonight, the University of Connecticut's women's team makes basketball history. Judy Woodruff has our story.
The team's victory over Notre Dame last night was its 71st consecutive win, an NCAA record. The streak dates back to November 2008. Behind it all is famed coach Gino Auriemma.
It's pretty remarkable. I'm probably tonight at some point I'll sit back and think, wow, you know, that's a lot of wins. And I guess it's better that we break our own record. I wouldn't want to break somebody else's record.
Monday's victory surpasses the school's last great winning streak that spanned from November 2001 to March 2003. The University of Connecticut, UConn, has dominated the women's game in recent years, winning 6 national titles. This year, even top teams haven't stood a chance. The Huskies have won every game in their 32-0 season by double digits.
I'm happy that we did it. It's done. We won't hear, oh my God, beat the streak. We're looking to win the next game, and that's what we've done. Look to do all season, and that's what we're going to continue to do.
Forward Maya Moore scored 11 points last night.
We know how special our team is, and we know what kind of a special thing we've got going, you know, over the past couple years.
If the UConn women continue to win into early next season, they would have a shot at breaking the 88-game record set by the UCLA men's team back in the 1970s. For now, instead of celebrating, the Huskies are concentrating on winning another title next month.
And for more about Connecticut's dominance and what it means for the sport, we're joined again by Christine Brennan of ABC Sports and USA Today. It's good to have you with us.
Thank you,
Jim. This time in person.
Thank you.
So this is a big deal for UConn.
Oh, it's a huge story. I mean, when you think about dominance and when you're mentioning the UCLA men's streak going back to the 1970s, almost any sports fan knows that. Here's UConn now at 71 and counting. Dominating teams, there's no threat of losing. It is extraordinary. And at the time of the most balance in women's sports, you know, with Title IX and so many things and advancements in women's sports, Judy, to think that you've got this kind of dominating team at this time in women's sports history, it's extraordinary.
So let's talk about why. A lot of attention to the coach, Gino Auriemma.
Yeah, oh, for sure. I mean, the cult of personality, that's what we're about in sports. And whether it's Kobe or Tiger or Lindsay from Lindsay Vonn, in this case, it's Gino. And Gino owns the state of Connecticut. And you've got this aura about this great program that he's developed over the years, so that almost any girl who plays basketball in the United States knows about UConn and wants to go there. And I think it does start with this man who's got this great ability as a personality to shine and to recruit, and also a fantastic basketball mind. And he has developed and really pulled in, I think, Judy, some of the greatest talent in the country at each position. He's got an all-star team, and it's all there at one university.
Well, is it that simple? Is it great coach, great recruiting? I mean, is that really all there is to the story?
I don't think so. I mean, I think it's a tradition of excellence, so that at UConn they expect to win. They expect to be great. And in fact, I love the strategy that they're talking about now, which is not so much playing the opponent, but playing the game and playing against themselves. And so they weren't entirely satisfied when they won that 71st game, because they know that they've got more to do. And it's Bobby Knight used to talk about this on the men's side, playing your game. Don't worry so much about the opponent, but do what's best and what you're best at. It's a great philosophy for dominating, you know, opponents.
Now, it wasn't so long ago that there were several women's college teams that were doing well. What changed? I mean, what happened?
It's a great question, and it concerns me. I must admit I'm a little worried about women's basketball. When you've got this kind of dominance, it would be one thing, Judy, to say this in 1990. Title IX was signed by Richard Nixon in June of 1972 that opened the playing fields of America to girls as well as boys. So I'd say 1990, even 2000, you'd expect this kind of dominance. I'm surprised that in 2010 we're seeing one team being so strong where there's no one getting within 10 points, 12 points. Stanford was in December. That's as close as anyone's gotten. This team has only been behind in 3 games in the second half of the 71-game streak. And I'm surprised, And I think it's a little worrisome that in the depth, with all these girls, you know, hundreds of thousands of girls playing basketball in our country, where is another team rising to the challenge? Right now, we don't see it.
Worrying for down the line, recruiting, getting girls interested to stay interested in college sports?
Well, and basketball, of course, is the national game, you know, for boys and girls. And you've got all these AAU tournaments and high school tournaments and, you know, dads starting their daughters just like their sons at age 4 and 5 and 6. So my question is, why now? I mean, I guess it's great that UConn is so fantastic. The flip side is, where are the 5, 6, 7, 8 other teams who are rising to the challenge? The hope would be that this is the future. What we're seeing with this incredibly professional style team, this dominating team, that 10 years from now, maybe there will be, 20 teams like this playing women's basketball.
What about the audience, whether they're watching in person or whether they're watching on television, Christine Brennan? What does that look like? I mean, that's been an ongoing struggle.
It has for women's sports. And I think maybe the victory is in participation as much as pro leagues or spectators. There certainly is an audience for women's sports. And at times like the Olympics or international events, you see quite an audience. But it pales in comparison to the men's audience, say for the men's Final Four versus the women's Final Four. And I think it's just one of those things that might take another generation or two. Maybe I'm a Pollyanna, but that maybe it will take the 10-year-old girl to be 40 years old and to have daughters and say, now we're all going to watch women's sports in a way that a 40-year-old woman might not say that now.
So what keeps these women athletes going? Obviously, individual stories, individual sports and teams, but what do you think keeps them going when they know they've pulled off this amazing achievement, 71 games, but the audience, the crowd isn't going to be.
Right, and it's still the men's tournament, and we don't even sometimes use that pesky adjective men's to describe, you know, the basketball tournament. President Obama last year does his bracket. He doesn't even say men's bracket. You know, it's as if there's this stepchild and it's the women's. I think it's college scholarships. I think it's interest locally. It's high schools. It's families caring about it, and it's the opportunity for girls, just like boys for generations, to learn about winning and losing at a young age, teamwork and sportsmanship. It makes better people, frankly. So Title IX is still working its magic. It just hasn't equated to great television ratings day in and day out for women's sports. Maybe it never will. Maybe it's simply participating and not having the pro sports interest or the great interest in the college game, but just the love of participating on that level.
Meantime, a record broken, UConn.
Absolutely.
Christine Brennan, great to see you. Thank you very much.
Judy, thank you. My pleasure.